Hi friends, Priya here. Today I am at Expressions Craft blog with my design team project. Today I am going to show some textures that I am going to create using the new release Art Essentials from Expressions Craft. These are the white and black heavy gesso, the texture paste and the crackle paste. We also have some dust, the magical fairy dust and some glitter dust. These are the new releases. For now, I have taken one canvas as my base and I'm taking some old book pages also to create some background textures on this. Instead of old book pages, you can also use some pattern papers or any kind of paper that you want to use on this base. So for this I am taking this heavy white gesso from Expressions Craft. It comes in a double lid jar for extra protection from leakage, and these are very creamy and these are heavy, so very thick. So if you want a little less creamy, then you can obviously add some water to it. You can see how beautifully the texture is, the gesso is coming over my canvas. So now I have taken this paper and I'm just speeding up my video a bit so that you'll not get bored. I am just sticking all these pieces of this old book pages onto my canvas using this heavy white gesso. I'll cover the whole canvas onto it, but I'm not going much onto the sides. I'm just preferring it on the back of on the front side of the canvas. On the sides I'm applying gesso but not the paper. Now I am using this texture paste from Expressions Craft, and with the help of a palette knife I am creating some more texture in the background. As you can see, I am just applying it randomly here and there and creating an uneven background for my canvas. You can do it with a brush, or you can make some more texture and add something else or some more designs. But here, as you can see, I want some abstract designs, so I'm just tapping my palette knife onto the texture that I applied. And now I'm going with the crackle paste and I will be applying it on the corners more and less into the center. I don't want it, I want the whole crackle onto this canvas. This crackle paste is really great. Now on to my second project. I am taking this sweet box that I got and I'm just taking the lower base of this box. Here I'm going to apply a coat of heavy black gesso from Expressions Craft. I want to create a canvas kind of a thing from this box and not a proper box from this, and I'll be thinking more about what I'll do with the cover of this box. For now, I want to create a canvas out of this base, and I'm applying this black gesso all over my box and will let it dry. This black gesso, as you can see, is like white gesso, is heavy and creamy, so you can always add some water if you want less thickness in this gesso. So now I am just drying it a bit. As you can see, I have this embellishment, this chipboard embellishment from Expressions Craft. Expressions Craft has got a lot of beautiful variety of chipboards, but here I'm not going to use this chipboard pieces. Rather, I'm going for this negative of this chipboard for my base. So I'll be cutting it out according to the size of the base, and here I'm just checking out the size where I want it, and then I'll just cut it out. And before gluing that onto my base, I'll just think that the base of my box is a bit on a lower side, so I will use this corrugated sheet before gluing this chipboard. So if you don't have a corrugated sheet, you can always go for your packaging box and just take out one layer and your corrugated sheet is ready. So here I'll be cutting it as per the size of my box, and I'll be distressing the edges of this sheet as well, because I want some more depth onto my project. If I would have been using a canvas, I would have loaded it with more textures, but because it is a cardboard box, I'm not sure how much load it's gonna hold, so I'm just going less on this. So as you can see, I'm attaching this sheet onto the box with the help of gel medium. So I'm not going to create a lot of layers here, but these two layers, and after that I'll see what more embellishments I can do. Now I'm mixing some sand with the gesso that I have taken out in this palette before, and I'm mixing them well, taking some more gesso and just mixing them well. Now I'll take some more black gesso and will be layering this sheet with it. Whenever I'm making some layered projects, be it a canvas, be it any 3D project, I always prefer to layer each base with gesso, so that the colors actually show up onto the project and everything should be clearly covered by the gesso, and the no white spot should be seen for my projects. I do that. So now I'm just drying it up a bit, and then moving on to this chipboard piece, I'm going to glue it onto the surface of this corrugated sheet. Now isn't it looking beautiful? I just love it. The design is so very pretty. I still have not thought what I'm going to do with this. Now, as you can see, I have mixed this sand with the black gesso. I could have mixed it with the texture paste, but then again, because I wanted it black, so I mixed it with the black gesso. You can mix it with texture paste, with crackle paste, with gesso, whatever you want. But because I didn't want to go again with a layering of gesso, because I wanted black, so I mixed it with my black gesso, and now I'm covering all the sides of this canvas with this sand texture, and also I'm adding it onto this chipboard piece, onto the sides and a little bit in the center also, but more onto the sides. Now I'm drying it, so just look at it, how beautiful it looks right now. So you can create a lot of textures like this using a lot of techniques. My next project will be on a MDF base. I've taken this small MDF base and I'm applying a coat of white gesso onto it. Thank you. taking some cheesecloth and I'm dipping it with my texture paste and gesso both, and I will be creating some texture, some random texture onto this MDF board. And I also have some thread with me, and I'll be creating some texture using both the cheesecloth as well as a thread here. So here you can see I just skipped a bit of video when I went to wash my hands after that texture paste. I just forgot to restart the video and I skipped a bit, but nothing much has gone. I have just created this project. This I made out of the packaging sheet from the handmade flowers from Expressions Craft. The flowers are very beautiful, and so are the packaging, the backside paper of the flowers. So I just took out one of them. As you can see, here are the flowers, and I just took out one packaging of such kind, this one. And I'm again going to show you how I did it because I skipped that bit. So I just took some tags from my, these are just ordinary cloth tags, price tags. So I just attached them onto this packaging paper with the help of white gesso. And there what I did is I just adhered another plastic sheet like this, plastic net, onto that burlap one. But here I'm going to apply some crackle paste instead of that plastic one. And there also I added some thread and some coconut coir, and after that dried I applied that burlap sheet. But here I'm just doing a little bit different. I'm just directly applying the crackle paste onto that base, and here also I'm applying the crackle paste onto the places where I have not given any texture. So I'll just leave them to dry. I'll just ask you to dry the crackle paste naturally instead of using a heat gun. Here you can see I just allowed it to dry naturally, and the cracks are looking really awesome. And this one is the second project, the box one, and here the ones we made with the cheesecloth and the thread. So what I'm doing is I'm just adding a bit of color just to show how the background is looking here. So I'm taking this sprinkle mist from Expressions Craft and just added randomly some rainbow kind of colors. Just drying it. Look at the pretty texture effect of this. I have yet not finished making this project. As you can see, where I skipped the video, I have added some art stones from MX here, and now I just added these colors. So isn't the texture beautiful? So I have not finished making it. In my next videos I am going to use all these backgrounds that I created here to make finished projects. Today this was all about the textures that I created, and I will be creating more nice projects on this basis in my videos to come. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and give us your feedback on Expressions Craft products. Thank you.